Violence continues to surge in Baltimore City. Officials pull together to come up with a new plan to combat crime. And that's our big story tonight at 6. The new plan was announced this morning by Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake.
Yes, indeed. It includes more prosecution power for the city using the long arm of the federal law. 11 News reporter Lowell Melzer is live downtown at City Police Headquarters. Lowell.
Yeah, Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake said earlier today that she will approve funding to bring in two additional assistant state's attorneys to work hand-in-hand with federal prosecutors to target the most violent offenders in the city. Since the last couple of weeks of June, there have been more than 50 shootings in Baltimore City, resulting in almost 24 murders.
Since taking office in 2010, I've made it clear that we will and I will do everything to support their efforts, because reducing violence remains one of my top priorities.
Thursday morning, Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake, flanked by State's Attorney Greg Bernstein, U.S. Attorney Rod Rosenstein, and Baltimore Police Commissioner Anthony Batts, told reporters she has approved funding for two additional assistant state's attorneys to work with the U.S. Attorney's Office to combat violent crime.
These new prosecutors will target the worst of the worst violent offenders in neighborhoods that have struggled the most with crime.
The city has had a long-standing arrangement with the feds. Currently, two assistant state's attorneys work with the U.S. attorney, and this will bring the total to four. City police and prosecutors will now be able to target the most violent neighborhoods in East and West Baltimore using federal resources, identifying the most dangerous criminals and prosecuting them in the federal system.
And it is because of this collaborative relationship with not only the U.S. Attorney's Office, but equally importantly, if not more importantly, the work that my office does with Commissioner Batts and his detectives and officers, that we are very hopeful that we're going to be successful.
The partnership also means these violent suspects will be incarcerated in federal prisons, separated from their affiliates and unable to continue their lives of crime in prison.
I think it goes without saying that the state's attorney's office needed help.
Mark Washington, executive director of the Cold Spring Homestead Montebello community, calls the move a step in the right direction. Washington points out his community has seen its share of violence, but that the community is involved, and that's key to making the whole process work.
I think federal prosecution of those most violent offenders is something that is needed, because it's only a small handful of individuals in the city of Baltimore that are committing these heinous acts.
And according to the mayor's office, the cost will be around $250,000 to hire these attorneys, something that I'm told was already budgeted for in this fiscal year. We're live downtown tonight. I'm Lowell Melzer, WBAL TV 11 News.
Lowell, thank you. And the latest effort to stem the violence may not seem all that new. For more than 30 years, mayors and police commissioners have been promising new plans to quiet the violent areas of Baltimore, but success has been limited. 11 News I-Team investigative reporter Jane Miller is live in the newsroom with more on that story. Jane.
Donna, violence is so ingrained in Baltimore's reputation, it spawned not one but two successful TV series. First, Homicide: Life on the Street, then The Wire. Both based not on fiction, but the real challenge of trying but failing to change dramatically, change the script.
December 5th, 1999, then Mayor Kurt Schmoke's last days as Baltimore's mayor, and a darkly fitting end. Five women were shot and killed in a house in Bel Air Edison. The year would end with 305 homicides, closing Baltimore's most violent decade. Now, in 2013, with the city too close to that kind of pace, current Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake announced she'll fund a stepped-up effort to prosecute violent offenders. It is a familiar pitch from City Hall. Since 1993, Baltimore has seen four mayors and eight police commissioners. Each has claimed to make violent offenders their biggest target. Tom Frazier's plan in the mid-1990s focused less on drug arrests, more on guns. Sound familiar? Fred Bielfeld was commissioner starting in 2007.
The biggest catalyst for violence in Baltimore are bad guys with guns.
Martin O'Malley, as mayor, made crime reduction his sole platform. He brought Ed Norris and New York-style policing to town. Later, with Leonard Hamm, his fourth police commissioner in charge, arrests soared, most for minor crimes. It had little effect on homicides, which averaged 265 a year during O'Malley's term. Since 1983, Baltimore's homicides soared through the late 80s and mid-90s, hitting a high of 353 in 1993. The number fell back in the last few years, but only once, in 2011, did the number dip below 200. It climbed to 217 last year, This year's pace is deadlier. And despite new and adjusted crime plans, Baltimore remains right where it was before, with a homicide rate in the nation's top five.
To date, the city has recorded 124 homicides, 11 more than the same time last year. Non-fatal shootings stand at 214, up 29 compared to last year. Reporting live tonight from the newsroom, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.